Welcome to this quick tutorial on a Blender to After Effects workflow. If you're watching this video, you probably realize that when you export EXR files from Blender, they don't contain the color management data. What I have open here is the Blender 3.5 splash screen by Nicole Marina. All I've done is convert it to a video format 16:9. If you go down to the color management settings, you can see that the view transform is Filmic, and the look is medium to high contrast. There's no exposure or gamma set, and there's no curves. What I'll do is I'll render out this image and save a JPEG file and an EXR file, and then we'll take it into After Effects. Okay, now that we've got After Effects open, I'll drag in both the JPEG and the EXR file. What you'll see is the JPEG information color is correct. But when I put the EXR on top, you can see that there is a distinctly different coloring. If I zoom in, you'll see that this is particularly noticeable around the highlights. That is because Blender has not saved the image as Filmic. It's actually saved it as standard with no look applied. In order to correct this, I've made myself a little plugin which I've released for free and open source on my webpage. It's possible to do it other ways using LUTs and different plugins. This is a simple plugin designed specifically for this task. The first thing we should do is go to the project settings, find the image in question, click Interpret Footage, Main, then under Color Management, press Preserve RGB, which disables After Effects as color management. As you can see, what the EXR file really contains is the standard Blender color mode with linear color. Now we'll search for the plugin, which is simply called Blender Filmic, and drop it on top. We'll change the input type to standard linear. And as you can see, things already look much better. We can then apply the Filmic look that we like. In this case, it's medium to high contrast. Now if we compare the two images, you can see that the coloring is the same. You also have the option to set the exposure and gamma as you would in Blender. Unfortunately, I haven't implemented the curves dialog yet. And that's it for this simple tutorial. Your EXR files now look exactly the same as in Blender. Go to my website, grab the plugin. It's also available for OpenFX if you want to use it in software like DaVinci Resolve.